Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released macOS Big Sur 11.4 to the public. This is available to all macOS Big Sur supported devices and is available at the same time everywhere around the world. Now this came in at 3.06 gigabytes. That's on the 2021 24-inch iMac, the brand new iMac Apple just released, and this was launched alongside iOS 14.6, iPadOS 14.6, watchOS 7.5, as well as tvOS 14.6 and HomePodOS 14.6. All of those updates are available now. Now let's go ahead and close this. We'll take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. So we'll go to the Apple in the upper left, click on About This Mac, and as you can see, it says version 11.4. If you click on the version number, you can see the build number of 20F71. So that's the current build number of the latest version available to the public. And as you can see, it's the M1 with 16 gigs of RAM, for example. So it may vary on the overall install size, depending on which device you're using. Let's go ahead and close this. And the first feature they've updated, or first change they've made, is something you can't see directly just yet, but support for RDNA 2 architecture from AMD. What that means is new graphics cards, whether or not that's coming to new M1 based iMacs or something newer that we're going to see at WWDC, or possibly just the standalone graphics cards that you could add to a Mac Pro. This update adds support for that according to Apple's notes. So we'll go ahead and close this. And the first change has to do with podcasts. Now, Apple updated podcasts and additional features in that with iOS 14.6, and they're bringing across the same sort of thing. Apple podcast subscriptions, for example, they'll be available to purchase via monthly or annual subscriptions. You won't necessarily have to use subscriptions, but it does add support for them. I don't see them yet. I'm not seeing anything in charts or anything like that. But also alongside that, there will be channels grouped together, which are collections of shows from podcast creators. So maybe there's a podcast that you listen to regularly, for example. So if we go into this show, or let's go to see all, maybe we'll go into this show. In here, we could see different podcasts that are grouped together. I'm not seeing any of these yet. So I'm imagining we're going to see more of these very soon once we see subscriptions or things like that, where we have different subscriptions to support our favorite creators, for example. So that was added in this particular update. So there's not a whole lot new within podcasts. If you use the podcast app, you'll appreciate the changes. They updated it greatly with macOS 11.3 also. Let's go ahead and close this out. Now, as far as new features, that's all that's in macOS 11.4. However, there are bug fixes as well. So if we go into Safari, for example, Apple has said that bookmarks in Safari may get reordered or moved into a folder that can appear hidden. So if you're using bookmarks and they're rearranged in a way that you didn't put them in, this should resolve that. Also, certain websites may not display correctly after your Mac wakes from sleep. So maybe you put your Mac to sleep, you wake it up, then you go to maybe Apple's website. Sometimes it may not appear as it should. I've actually seen this before this update where it would be sort of a small window inside the larger window. So that should be fixed in this update. Now, if we go into the Photos app, they've fixed something as well. So if we close Safari here, here's the Photos app. And as you can see, I take a bunch of different photos for the thumbnails and things, but this gives you an idea. And if we go into maybe this one, when you export a photo, for example, and you add keywords, so maybe you're adding keywords to this, you want to add a keyword that this is Apple TV, for example. Sometimes that wouldn't export when you exported it. That has been resolved in Photos. Now, another thing they've fixed has to do with preview. So maybe you're in preview, you're searching for a PDF document. Sometimes it would become unresponsive. That has been updated now, so it should work properly. Now, the last thing they've fixed has to do with a specific game. This is kind of unusual that they fix something to make a specific game work. But if we go to the App Store, for example, they've fixed an issue with Civilization 6. So we go to Civilization 6, or there we go. In Civilization 6, there was an issue where it could become unresponsive when playing on a 16-inch MacBook Pro. So this has been resolved. It's kind of an odd thing we haven't seen too many times where it's specific to a game, but they've resolved that as well. Now, there are security updates in this update that are pretty significant. So if we go into Safari here, you can see these are macOS Big Sur 11.4 security updates. There's quite a bit, everything from AMD to the App Store to Core Audio to the dock to graphics drivers, and we can go on and on. So if I keep scrolling down, you'll see the kernel as well, login window. There's quite a few updates in this as far as security. So you'll see it just keeps going on and on. And that's good. The Apple continues to update security for macOS. And you'll see there's a ton of different updates in this, giving information as who submitted it, what the issue was as far as the impact, and what they did to fix it. So all of these things have been fixed in macOS 11.4, and I'll link this security page in the description below if you want to check this out for yourself. So quite a few things fixed in this, and that leads me to, should you install macOS 11.4? And I would say for the bug fixes and security updates alone, it's worth it, along with iOS 14.6, for example. So all of those security updates have been added. So that's everything in macOS 11.4. So far, it seems responsive. I've been using it for a little bit, haven't had any issues, but let me know if you've found anything new or experienced any issues in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link the iOS version for you in the description below. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.